Welcome into Three High Safeties. Austin Gayle here with my guys Ben Linsey and Mike Renner, ready to rip it up after a very good Sunday slate in Week 6. Let's start with this. Green Bay Packers got absolutely rocked by Tom Brady and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Does this change who your favorite in the NFC is? Mike, I'll start with you.
I don't think so. I still think they have a far better defense than the Seattle Seahawks, who are still undefeated. I think that the Buccaneers' offense is far too inconsistent for me to get on board with them. So I think we've seen this high-end play from the Packers that I'm still going to call them the favorite. But you saw some issues offensively. They don't really have a lot of options outside of Davante Adams. And if David Bakhtiari really is out for a long period of time, more pressure on Aaron Rodgers spelled his worst game easily of the season. So I think that's maybe going to be the book going forward, is just going to have to bring guys and get in his face and make it uncomfortable for him there in the pocket.
Yeah, call it an overreaction if you want. But I am ready to say the Buccaneers are the best team in the NFC. And you talked about those offensive inconsistencies, but you look at Brady, what he did in New England, what Arians has done throughout his career. That's a big change that Brady has to get used to. And he's still playing well through that adjustment. Their receivers have been banged up. They're finally getting Godwin back. Gronk is coming back off retirement. He had his best game last week. And I just think their defense gives them a leg up over Seattle. I trust their defense more. They've drafted really well in the secondary in recent years with guys like Carlton Davis, Jamel Dean, Antoine Winfield. I think they're the most complete team in the NFC.
I like Tampa Bay maybe moving up as the favorite. I also really like the Seahawks, and it's easy to overreact to Green Bay. But I think the real story here is that it's close. It's very close. Green Bay, Seattle, Tampa Bay, all three really good teams in the NFC. I think what the better story is, all three of these teams have clear weaknesses for them to be buyers at the trade deadline. Green Bay needs receivers outside of Davante Adams. Seattle has zero pass rush whatsoever. And Tampa Bay, those inconsistencies, I think they need to get healthy and also maybe add a piece in addition to Chris Godwin, Mike Evans, try and find ways to get top of Brady, to go over the Green Bay Packers and Seattle Seahawks. Each team is a couple pieces away from being the clear favorite in the NFC. I'd like to see all three teams try and make some moves at the trade deadline.
I'll give you a name. Week 9, one guy's available to play. It's Antonio Brown. He might swing the balance of power there in the NFC. All right, let's kick it to our next topic here. Monday Night Football slate. We got Kansas City traveling to Buffalo. A nice little 5 p.m. or maybe not nice for the West Coast, but out here on the East Coast, I love that start time. Ben, where do you see this one heading?
Yeah, I mean, both of these teams are looking for bounce back games. The Bills got blown out by Tennessee. The Chiefs lost to the Raiders. But I think I have more faith in Kansas City bouncing back. I think Andy Reid, Patrick Mahomes, gets their offense clicking, looking like it did against Baltimore, and I think they get the win.
Yeah, Chiefs enter this game on the road as 5.5-point favorites. I think they clear that number, win this game by a touchdown. I don't think it's necessarily that Josh Allen continues to trend down. He's still the fourth-ranked quarterback according to PFF grade so far this season. I think it's going to be a bit of an offensive shootout, actually, but I think Kansas City in the shootout is the way to go.
Yeah, you also thought Kansas City was going to cover that number last time against the Raiders.
Stop.
I'm going to go the other way here. I'm going to go the Buffalo Bills because of kind of what we saw, those weaknesses in the Chiefs defense down the field last week against the Raiders, against some speed, against some good route runners, which the Bills obviously have one of the best in the NFL in that, and Stephon Diggs. I think the Bills score some points on them, keep it close, and I trust their defense a little more at this point than I trust the Chiefs defense.
Other Monday night game we got tonight is Cardinals-Cowboys. The Cardinals offense has been looking a little bit shaky in recent weeks. Obviously, Dallas going with Dalton instead of Dak after his injury. Who do you like tonight, Austin?
I woke up this morning absolutely ecstatic to bet the bankroll on Andy Dalton and the Dallas Cowboys. I think they're favored by 1.5. It could be the other side in some spots, but I really do think this Dallas Cowboys offense, yes, it does take a step back. They're not a better offense without Dak Prescott. It doesn't make the defense better or whatever take you got there, but what it is, it's not as big of a step back as maybe the market thinks it is. I think Andy Dalton can still lead this team to a comfortable win over an overrated Arizona Cardinals team. Cliff Kingsbury is overrated. Kyler Murray has a very low average depth of target, isn't being asked to do a ton of things for Arizona. I think that offense is overrated. I hate to root against Kyler Murray. He's a fun player to watch. I like him running for his life, running around the football field. But I think the Dallas Cowboys win this game by more than 3.
Yeah, you said the Arizona Cardinals offense has been struggling. Well, the Cowboys defense has been the get-right game basically for every offense they've faced this season. Going to get shredded, I believe, on the ground this game by Kyler Murray and Kenyon Drake. I just think that this Arizona offense, yes, they have struggled in recent weeks. Yes, there are some issues in terms of what they like to do offensively, and Austin touched on it. They're just throwing the ball, peppering it underneath. They got to go downfield a little bit more to someone other than DeAndre Hopkins. But I think against that Dallas defense, that's the defense to do it again. If it doesn't happen this week, it's not happening at all.
I'm gonna break the tie inside with Austin. Go with Dallas in this one. I know the injuries are starting to pile up, but I have faith in Andy Dalton. And they still have those wide receivers. Arizona runs a lot of man coverage, and I like their wide receivers getting open against those Arizona cornerbacks. DJ Humphries is questionable. If he misses, that would be a big boost for the Cowboys pass rush. Alden Smith, Marcus Lawrence, both playing well.
You want to get rid of me and get back to more great PFF YouTube content? All you have to do is push that button right there and subscribe. Thanks for watching.